neglect to stop IPOP, Prophet TB Joshua advised Nigerian government. The General Overseer of the Spiritual Director, Synagogue Church of All Nations, Senior Prophet TB Joshua, has told the Nigerian presidency that they acted late over the agitation of the indigenous people of Biafran's the quest to be liberated and separated from the current one Nigeria. The prophet was reacting on the statement attributed to the presidential aide on media and publicity, Garba Shehu, who publicly came to state that IPOB is discrediting the nation international league and has called for an international committee to disregard the allegation being leveled upon IPOB members. The federal government of Nigeria, by the group he has tagged as a terrorist group. These are individuals who hold nothing like AK-47 in their hands. They are simply agitators in a peaceful and diplomatic way. From my understanding, why should they be labeled as terrorist groups when those who go about killing Christians in Nigeria are seen to be the ones that should have good positions in the government of the current administration? The clergy further stated that the government did not act swiftly to the heavy information and allegations by the well-informed IPOB leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, whom he referred to as a godsend to his people and the Moses of our time, whom God in heaven has given the mandate to liberate his people to the promised land called Biafra. I have to make it clear to the whole world as a prophet of God that the reaction from the presidency is rather coming too late at this point in time, because they have gone and far ahead of the Nigerian government and has gotten the attention of the international community, which is now the current discussion all over the world. I therefore urge the government of Nigeria to understand and allow them to be as they have decided that they want to have their own nation called Biafran. Therefore, the government should leave them to fulfill their dreams, he concluded. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news. TB Joshua is right. This is an intelligent man of God talking. But a point of correction: Biafran is not trying to separate from Nigeria, because Nigeria is never a country. Biafrans are simply coming what God created them to be, is a nation. Biafran is a nation that will bring light and freedom to the black people. If Biafran leave or separate from Nigeria today, I pray that Nigeria will not end up collapsing, because Biafrans are the Igbos. If Igbo leaves the country today, leaves Nigeria today, then the remaining tribes would definitely suffer for it. Those tribes that have developed hatred for Igbos, that developed hatred for Biafrans and the leader of Biafra, would definitely regret if Biafran eventually separates from this country. I see no reason why they should be having this hateful mind for Biafrans and Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of indigenous people of Biafra. My advice to these Fulanese, Hausas and Yorubas that have hatred for this country, for this nation Biafran, should come or should erase that hatred from their mind, from their hearts, and support Nnamdi Kanu for Biafran's agitation. Support Nnamdi Kanu to get Biafran Republic. If not, if Biafran or Nnamdi Kanu eventually succeed in getting Biafran Republic, I so much sorry for those people. I so much sorry for the Northerners. I so much sorry for the Yorubas and those that are developing hatred for the people of Biafra. They should unite with the Biafrans. They should unite with Nnamdi Kanu so that when Biafran finally separates, then they will be among those that will go with Biafra. Okay, that they will be among those that will form and start up Biafran land. But if they refuse to do this, if they refuse to wipe off the hatred they have for Biafrans, I'm very much sure that they will definitely suffer for this. And by that time, it might have been too late for them to come back, for them to join, or for them to become Biafran again. So Biafran are simply coming because God has created them to be a nation that will bring light and freedom to the black people, a nation that will liberate Africa from the shackles of Benin Conference, a black nation that will stand shoulder to shoulder with the white nations, a kingdom of God on earth. As for me, I think Nigerian government should give Igbo people their own freedom. If it is the will of God, no one can stop their freedom. The only words I don't like from some of them is by saying is because without them, the other tribes in Nigeria can't survive. That was a childish talk. God have created every human beings with their provision. So, no one should be saying without them or others can't survive. That is a wrong statement. It's a wrong statement. I still don't understand it that Yoruba and Igbo will always call, Yorubas and Hausas will always call Igbos unprintable names. But each time Biafran is mentioned, they will be attacked by emotional coronavirus when they directly say evil about the Biafrans. Imagine this. I don't know why the Hausas and Yorubas hate Igbos with so much passion. I advise them to reunite with the Igbos before it's too late. Because if Igbo leaves this country, the Yorubas and the Hausas will become slaves to Nigeria and the government. So the earlier the better. The truth is bitter. The earlier the better for them to join. The earlier the better for them. If they refuse to join, if they refuse to support Biafra, then when the time comes for them to join Biafran again, then it might then be too late for them. It might be too late for them. So may God bless TB Joshua for the statement and allow Nigerian leaders to understand what TB Joshua is saying and allow Biafra to get its freedom. Nnamdi Kanu and IPOB would definitely succeed in the struggle. because God is the author of the new Biafra. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news and the comments that I've given. If you have any comments or any advice for the government, don't hesitate to drop them below the comment box. Click on the subscription button as well as the bell button to receive updates. Thank you.